What up, guys? It's your boy Dirty Work in the building. This is world-class audio right here behind me. It's very unassuming. We're right here in Riverside, California. It's a beautiful day. You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, my man Shawn Sullivan just came out. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was just wrecking your audio talking in there, so.
He's like, oh.
Just so you know.
You know what I'm saying? He's talking crap about us. It's all good.
Nah.
Right, so we're going to go ahead and take you guys, and we're going to give you guys a straight walkthrough. Actually, I'm going to let him explain everything, because he
knows. Okay, yeah, cool. I'm assuming this is still going.
Yeah.
Come on in.
Mic check.
Rusty front door.
Oh. Right, this place is awesome.
Yeah, so, yeah. Big old entry.
Yeah.
Here's the control room, which the floor is Fender rosewood neck blanks from the Fender Custom Shop. So there's actual fretboards on the floor, or fretboard blanks. Got a 1978 museum condition ARP 2600 chilling over there, which is lovely.
That part.
Not mine yet, but I'm actually in process of getting it. We got a 1950 Cinema Engineering tube pre's over here. Yes, and then we got a Hamptone tube pre. So 8 Harrison modified pre's by Jim Williams. The Coil Audio mic pre's, which are mic pre's based on a 1929 Western Electric patent. Old tube pre's, they use new old stock tubes, new old stock capacitors, etc. Got a Antelope Audio Goliath, but I have a Lynx Aurora N, their next generation converters on the way, 24IO.
Man.
Just made my wallet red hot again.
What are those speakers, though?
Speakers are ATC SCM200s that have been modified with Rawl ribbon tweeters and ScanSpeak illuminators, and then they've been completely gone over, customized, and custom crossover, and phase aligned, time aligned, group delay compensated. It's all...
Hashtag a lot of money.
Hashtag a lot of money, yeah. And a lot of time and energy. Right, and, of course, right. I'm running Pro Tools 2020 HDX, new version of that. And there's more gear on the way. I have a stereo Verimu Federal compressor on the way that is built by a buddy of mine. That's what drums look like when you have about 500 edits on it. Let me scroll out. There you go. Anyway, so that's his tracking.
Yeah. Not mixed, not mastered yet. But
No. That
is what he does. And then he has a whole slew of
Yeah, I got a whole slew of guitars. So I've got the 2020 Music Man, HH Stingray, 1969, 1969 Gibson J45. Got a nice 90s Takamine solid top, classical back there. Evertune 1983 Ibanez, which is like my main kind of rock metal guitar. It's all taped up.
Stitches.
1990s G&L ASAT Tele, 1965 Framus back there, 1977 Guild D50.
He's got everything.
There's more guitars in the other room. We got a three-channel tube mixer down here I used to sum guitar tracks with. And then there's it's called Neil Before Zod is the name of that. That's the name of it, of that DI, which is an all-tube octal DI. And then, yeah, we can make our way to the other room.
And the seating and everything is all cool. Oh, and this is your conversation piece, right?
That's a conversation piece. That's a 1936 VI meter, which before there was such a thing as a VU meter, there was a thing called a VI meter, which is just a different voltage and stuff that it would operate at. But we have like a little microphone there, and we have like actually a mic trim here, and then this is just our
the lights.
Lights.
Oh, wow.
Fade in and out.
That's an old Variax. That's super dope.
So it's just a conversation, working museum piece, basically.
All right.
And of course, in here, got.
And this is where we get litty. Like two big ass titties. You know what I'm talking about?
We've gotten litty in here already a couple times. But
yeah.
So, yeah, got the bar, bathrooms over there.
Yeah.
You know, et cetera.
This is crazy. Is this an airplane wing?
It looks like one. It's built to look like one.
He's got an airplane wing table.
You see all my mess of soldering over there.
This is crazy.
I've got big ass hallway.
Big ass bumble clock.
That's where big mess in there is where the computer and cables and some microphones are.
Yeah, man.
It's a mess.
Control room.
It's a mess. Upstairs, we got storage. And then, of course, in here is like a big, you know, big tracking room.
Now, this right here is the Bumbleclot spot right here, my name.
Bumbleclots. So, a bunch of vintage amps. Got like a mint 1959 Tone Master, 1961 Gibson Invader, like an old 60s projector amp that was made into a combo amp. I love that thing, actually. 1986 Roland Jazz Chorus, 1963 Ampeg Flip Top. You know, no big deal. hand-wired Fender Vibrolux. Actually, it was built by a friend of mine, but it is a Vibrolux, hand-built. And we got a 1988 Red Tolex, because that's like the unicorn. 1988 Red Tolex, Marshall JCM 800 on the top. Satriani JVM Marshall right there on the bottom, both great amps. 1970s Marshall checkerboard with original G12H pre-Rolla speakers.
And then
we got like a Maple Fives kit. I was lucky enough to get one of these Fives kits before they shut down in 2005. And we got a 36-pound Gretsch phosphor bronze snare. Anyway, so got an old Sonar kick, but I also have the kick that actually goes with the Fives kit over there. Then we got more guitars.
Way more guitars.
Old Strat over there. Actually, not even old. 1939 Star piano. Little baby grand. Yeah. That works great. Gets used more than I thought it would. It's nice to have.
Yeah, man.
And then we got, you know, acoustically designed, about 1,000-square-foot room. It was all mathed out, and it's, you know, I could go into some detail on that, but it just sounds really good and clean.
I slept on it. Great Z's.
Yeah.
Great Z's are the same.
The one in the lobby, actually, is really, I've slept Z's, on too many Z's. Times by great too many Z's. Guys. But
I hope only slept.
I think mostly. It's almost all dudes, so yeah, it's going to be.
Well, you never know.
Some
of those dudes.
That's true. Some of these guys.
A little rock and roll.
A little rock and roll. Crazy, you know? Oh, yeah, yeah. This is a Flea 47, so it's their Flea 47 vintage, which is literally a handmade part-for-part replica of a U-47, all the way down to the actual head will swap out onto a U-47. Capsule is the exact same thing that they use
super
for the
dope.
U-47. So basically, it's like buying a new U-47 is what it is.
Right?
Yeah, it's not cheap, but it's still cheaper than getting a vintage 47, which is you're paying because it's old, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And they're badass, so
yeah,
but I'm very, very happy with that mic.
I just love the look and feel of this place, man. It just reminds me of like something out of like the 70s sometimes.
That's cool. Good.
Sometimes,
yeah,
it's
I kind of wanted to go for that, like it's been here forever look, you
yeah,
know
vibe,
I wanted that feel for sure.
I can dig it. Can you dig it? Because I can dig it. It's Doug, baby, you know what I'm saying? Jack, you jive turkey.
And then there's you know, pair of Telefunken M60s up over on the overheads.
Did he say?
I've got a couple vintage 451s for the hi-hat and ride. I've got Telefunken M83 for kick. Also, it goes on and on and on for mics. There's quite a few. I have a Steger ribbon mic, SR1, which is in the hallway. Printed stereo, Fostek stereo ribbon mic, which is trippy right there. So that's it's a bastard child between a dynamic and a ribbon. Like, they made it and made a mic, and that's that mic, which is literally...
It's a dibbin.
It's a ribbon printed on a dynamic.
Yeah, it's a dibbin.
It's a dibbin.
It's a dibbin. It's a dibbin, babe. It's a dibbin. Yeah, for sure.
So it's got a front-facing cardioid and then a bi-directional printed ribbon, yeah.
That is crazy.
It's crazy. Yeah, it's weird.
It's crazy. And he knows all about this stuff, so, you know.
Got a modded old 70s 414 over here, modded by Jim Williams. I love it. One of my favorite mics ever is right there, the EV N68, which is, you know, like $200, and they're awesome. Like, you can put that up against just about anything, and it kills for micing up kick drums and that kind of stuff.
Awesome, awesome.
And on it goes, man. 421s, all the standards, 441 Sennheiser, 421s, bajillion 57s, you know.
And it goes on and on and
it
on.
It goes
on
and on. 40 Audio-Technica 4047s, I love those. I have a couple of those. I wish I had two more.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Well, that's the tour.
There you go.
If you have any questions, please put it down there. Book your sessions, right? We're right here in Riverside. It's world-class audio. Riverside is my man, Shawn Sullivan. So that's the tour. This place is awesome. If you have any questions about any of the gear or, you know, where to get it, how to get it, you know what I'm saying, go ahead and leave a comment below. You know what I'm saying? But please like and subscribe. Like and subscribe, right? Like, yeah. And we out. We will see you.